You know, as a believer, or if Jesus is in your life, you want to by nature make a difference. You want to see the world change. You want to see lives change. You want to see miracles happen. You know, so sometimes it's not that you don't want to. It's just that maybe you don't know how, and you don't want to be embarrassed, or you don't want to embarrass people. You know, those are things that people struggle with. So it's important that you know how. You know how to make a difference, how to make a change. Okay, the emphasis of all things being possible with God is not placed on God, because that is common sense. It's obvious God, who created everything, can do anything. So the emphasis is placed on man. Okay, so the emphasis is placed on you, that all things are possible with God. Amen? Amen? Okay, so anything and all things are possible. Okay, so we said we're going to Hebrews chapter 2, my favorite scripture. Amen. Verse 8. Remember, we started where Jesus is seated. Okay? So verse 8, it says, "For you have put everything in subjection under his feet." Speaking of Jesus, okay? All right, under his feet. Now, in putting everything in subjection to man, he left nothing outside of man's control. But at present, we do not yet see all things subject to him, to man. All right, so it says he left nothing. He left nothing outside of man's control. Okay, so when it says nothing, it means nothing. Nothing is out of man's control. Then it goes on to say, but we do not yet see all things subject to man. So, you have authority. Okay, you know what? I think it was Joseph Prince. I don't know who said it. He said, if you're a king and you're not ruling, it doesn't mean you're not king. It just means you're a stupid king. Okay, so we have been placed in a position of authority, and maybe we do not yet see all things subject. It's important to know that nothing is outside of control. So it's important to know yet. So there's something we got to do. Amen. So we will see all things subject to us. Okay. Seeing speaks about materially seeing it. It's God's intention for man to rule on earth. So now, if you are in construction and you're digging foundations and you're doing stuff. So now, say there is a big boulder that needs to be moved. If you, with your physical strength, go and you try to move the boulder, there is no way that you can do that. Okay, so with natural strength, as hard as possible as you want to, you can't do it. Okay, so you need extraordinary strength. So what we would do is you get a bulldozer. With the bulldozer, you can move the boulder. And as soon as you get in the bulldozer, you get a supernatural strength. Okay? You are moving that boulder, but you're using something to do that. Okay? Are you with me? Now, in the same way with us, maybe we do not yet see all things subject to man. You know, if you take a Land Rover and you put it in Africa, in the bush somewhere, and you say, hey, I just want to bless you with it, and it's got air conditioner, it's got all these great things, and next thing you come back and they've never used it before. It's just been landing there because they didn't know what this thing can do. Okay? The bulldozer, with you in it, it has to operate with the way you want it to. If you push the lever a certain way, it will go a certain way. Okay, so you drive it with your intention. When you push the lever, it will move the boulder. Now, it is the same thing with us. God has given us a tool. Okay, and that tool is called the Spirit. Now, for many years, we've quoted Isaiah, where it says, "Here I am, Lord, use me." Nothing wrong with that. But with the Spirit and with the ability of the Spirit, it's actually the other way around. It's you using the Spirit. Okay? So it's you making the decision. And with your intention, it's a supernatural power. Okay? It's important to understand that it doesn't control you like you some kind of robot. Okay? So we're going to look at that. Is that good?